ABB Familia, how are we today, team? Yesterday, I posted a question regarding would you rather 2 hours of time or would you rather $200 a day? And it was interesting, the answers that came back, and there's no real right or wrong answer with that. It obviously is individual to your circumstances and how you feel about it, but it was really, really interesting and got Jimmy and myself thinking about it. And we've used this analogy before, so we just wanted to share with you an opportunity or a way that you might be able to save yourself some time or work out where you're spending all of your time and then start to dedicate it to the areas that are important. So what we've got is 168 hours in a week, okay? So that's everyone's got that time, that's all that there is. And what we've done is we've used the major categories and we've even overcompensated a bit in most of it. And of what a normal week to a normal person would be. Yes, there's going to be differences from person to person, but I wanted you to just start to think about where you spend your time and what time you actually have left over that we choose to probably do things that sap a lot of our time when we could be using it to do things to get to where we want to get to. So if we start with, say, work for instance, average person, right, 40 hours a week. Some people might be 50, but just keep that in mind as I go through this as a guide, okay? 40 hours a week, work. Travel time, then based on 3 hours a day, so people that are traveling into the city, and it might be an hour and a half each way, then that's 15 hours in a week gone. Sleep time, I've allocated 8 hours. Now, I don't know about you, but I don't get 8 hours of sleep, and I should, but that's overcompensating again. So if you only get 6 or 7, then that hour mark is gonna come down again and you're gonna have even more time, all right? Meal time, so we put allocated 14 hours for that, and that is just breakfast and dinner, okay? Because generally if we're at work, that lunch time is gonna be included in the hours that we're at work. So we've basically allocated, 2 hours a day to brekkie and dinner. And then family time, those 30 hours is, you know, the time that you spend when you get home from work with the family. Or it could be on the weekends, etc. And like I know with myself, even though I work from home, I don't spend much time with the family at all, like in the evening. So even that's a bit of an overcompensation. And then on the weekends is probably where the bulk of that time is spent with them. So like in total, these are the main categories that the bigger chunks of our time go. And we worked out 155 hours out of that 168. So that leaves us with 13 hours in the week to do whatever we want, okay? So look, yes, there's cleaning and things like that. There's Facebook, there's Twitter, there's Instagram, there's all those things, TV, but we choose to watch those things and be on the phone, and that is time sapping, okay? So yes, it's great, like I get on there, I enjoy being on there, but it's how much time are you on there? Because 5 minutes can turn into 10, can turn into 20, can turn into half an hour that you're spending on these things that probably aren't that important to you and probably aren't going to get you to where you want to go. And a good reason for us to do this too is just to show people that you've got 13 hours, all we ask for is 3 to work out with us and you're well on your way to like a healthier lifestyle, okay? So in that analogy, like even if you took 3-4 hours of training out, you've still got 9 or 10 hours to put towards the things that don't really matter, okay? Or that you want to do, the things that you choose to do. So it's all about that choice. So I hope that's got you thinking. We've got a spreadsheet that Jimmy's put together where you can go into greater detail so you can have different things allocated for these categories and really break down where do you spend your time each day? And we've got it done by day, so Monday to Sunday. And then you can work out, shit, you know what, I spend way too much time doing Facebook or on Facebook or Instagram or whatever it might be. Maybe I can cut that back and allocate a time in the day to do it and spend time at training, preparing meals, eating healthier, spending time with the family, you know, all that sort of stuff that's important to you and will get you to where you see yourself. That's where you've got to spend that time where you're probably overdoing it. So I really hope that's helped. And Jimmy's behind the camera. If you've got anything to add, mate, then throw it at him now. Otherwise, we'll send you the spreadsheet and we'll go from there.
Well said, guys. Choose to make some time to plan your nutrition, to plan your training, and do that for the rest of your life.
We love you. Think about it. When the spreadsheet comes out, just have a crack at it. Like, just spend 10 minutes having a crack and you might save yourself some time. I hope that helps, team. We'll speak to you soon.